I didn't ever want to be known as that artist that's always collaborating, and I feel like in the Latin industry, it was like popping off. That's what everybody was doing.
On this episode of Cultura Clash, it's all about music collaborations.
I feel like I was on songs that were really big, but that didn't mean that I actually grew my fan base.
Are collabs a must-have for artists these days, or more trouble than it's worth?
I work with some producers that have that high name profile, and they ain't doing nothing. Like, they sleeping.
When is a collab clout chasing, and when should an artist say no?
I just gotta like the song to make it happen. If not, it's not gonna happen.
We're breaking it all down right here, sin filtro.
I've always made it very clear, I never really made music to be on lists.
Always tackling the hottest topics in Latin music and culture. Oh yeah, this is Cultura Clash.
Dímelo, dímelo, dímelo. Welcome to Cultura Clash. With us today are three phenomenal artists making increíble música and pushing our culture hacia adelante. The rising global star putting Chile on the map, singer Paloma Mami. A 10-year vet of the game, banda and norteño singer Gerardo Ortiz. And last but not least, the Grammy-winning Miss Noche y Día Telepatía herself, singer Kali Uchis. So today, vamos a tener una conversación. We're going to keep it honest, open, and transparent. Sin filtro. Welcome to Cultura Clash. Collaborations, are they a friend or a foe? Are they necessary at this moment?
I think collaborations is super, super important. Since the beginning, I always was working by myself. I've definitely learned that being with more people in a studio and just kind of vibing off people that you wouldn't even expect to be working with. Like, you could be vibing with them in the studio and you come up with an amazing song that's perfect for you. Like, you would have never guessed that. So I think collaborating helped me so much in my career. Like, definitely learned so much from so many different, not even just other artists or writers, just producers as well.
I agree with like what Paloma was saying about how sometimes it can be nice to kind of learn from other people, but also like how she started alone. Like, I started alone in my room. So for me, I actually love working alone. If you're super talented and you have a song that's really powerful, I think that you don't necessarily need another person on the song in order for it to do good. The way that I've always looked at features personally in my career, like, I always only just work with people that I really like and I really fuck with, and I have to kind of meet somebody first and be like, oh, I really like what they got going on or whatever, to want to do a song with them. I don't do music with a lot of people. As a young artist, there was a lot of like big artists who put me on songs when I was young, but that's why I'm saying I don't think that it's necessarily necessary, because I feel like I was on songs that were really big, but that didn't mean that I actually grew my fan base from those songs. You know, like, for instance, I was on Get You, Daniel Caesar, and that song became such a huge song, but it's like my part in it was like so small that it didn't really do a lot for me, I felt like. It's still an honor to be a part of it. Daniel, like, nobody knew who Daniel was at the moment. I was a fan of a song that he had, and I was like, yeah, we should do something, da-da-da, and then he sent me that record, and I was like, I love this record, I want to be a part of it for sure, and I jumped on it. So it's like, you never know. It's not necessarily that, like, if you're a part of a bigger person's song, whatever, okay. But at the end of the day, that person's song is that person's song. I feel like, personally, when you have your own song and it's your own thing going on and you don't need anybody else to get on the song for it to be big, that shows a lot more about, you know, what you can do.
You also won a Grammy for our collaboration with K-Trinada.
Yeah, he produced it, but I wrote the entire song and it's only my voice on the song. So he's the producer who, like, his music is like, it says like featuring artists, but it's like his voice isn't actually on the song, you know, so it's a little bit different, but yeah.
Love it. Gerardo, háblame de ti.
Nuestra música es diferente, and our music is different because you start by yourself. You know, our music is more cultura, representa más el color de nuestras raíces. Entonces es más difícil para conectar en otros sonidos y en otros géneros. But now you got a mix with different genres, and I don't know, like you say, you know, fans, you know, all their fans could hear my music.
You cross promote each other.
Yeah, that my music comes from another world. So that's the way it could help, you know.
Your own music on its own, like solo music, having its own identity is way more important than doing features.
Yeah, can I say that? Like, I was thinking, like, amazing that you got a Grammy. To say that you did that all by yourself is like so incredible. For me, when I sing songs, like my first song, for example, Not Steady, I literally did that shit on my computer and stuff with SoundCloud beats, and that was the first time I actually recorded a song. And so knowing everybody like loved that song because it went pretty viral in Chile and stuff, and they would be singing like my own lyrics that I wrote by myself when I was like in a bum ass studio, like, it's so crazy to think that that's like what people really love. And I feel like that's closer to your heart than stuff that you work, even though it's amazing, obviously collaborating with other people and writers and stuff like that, but I feel like it's like...
Más original,
¿verdad? Es más original.
Yeah, because your fans can feel your essence, your identity, yeah. And yeah. When you let other people take over too much, it definitely gets lost in that.
Yeah.
Paloma Mami, your debut album, right? Sueño de Dali, you did this on your own, no features, no collabs. Did you feel pressure of just doing this on your own?
Yeah, actually, no, not at all. Because since I started making music, I always, like, I didn't ever want to be known as that artist that's always collaborating. And I feel like in the Latin industry, that was, like, it was, like, popping off, like, at the moment that I had just started. And that's what everybody was doing. I would see, like, sadly, lots of people always would make comments saying that, oh, they don't do anything by themselves. Like, they're always collaborating with this person. Like, what's their identity? Like, people really weren't sure of the artist's essence. And I feel like I've always wanted to show who I am as an artist, always be super, super honest with my fans. And I felt like by doing a whole album by myself, no features or anything, was like the best way I could do it. I just wanted people to know who I am and what I feel, you know? And I felt like no features kind of did that. With my debut album, Gold in the US, I was like so proud of that. That's so huge for me, like, is honestly just like doing a song by yourself, writing it all by yourself is like so close to the heart and it makes me feel so proud.
¿Has sentido la presión, o sea, perhaps to your management or your label, like, hey, let's get more collaborations going and flowing?
Yo creo que desde tiempo más atrás, we talked about probably like Juan Gabriel or Vicente Fernandez or Joan, like they all work on their own music, you know, their own sound, en las letras. Entonces, nunca sucedieron esas cosas. I remember años atrás pasó con Juan Gabriel y Rocío Durca y fue una bomba, a todo el mundo le gustó, but I don't know, a lo mejor los celos, también como representar tu propio sonido, tu propia esencia, like your own way of doing your music, your own sound. That's the way it works over here, you know, in our music. But I see in otros géneros, en tiempos atrás no pasaba. Entonces, now that it's happening, it's good and it's fun.
Do you get pressure from the culture, from the industry, to do more collaborations? And how do you turn them down nicely?
I feel like it's what Kali said. Like, I'm like that too. I'm very specific about who I want to work with. I've done literally like two collabs in my whole career. And I feel like if you really resonate with the person's music and everything they stand for, and not only just that, they're also personality. That is like what makes me want to collab with somebody for sure.
¿Tú sientes la presión, Gerardo?
For me, it's more like me wanting to do, like, get into another sound or
yeah,
otro mundo. Like, como cuando hice bachata con Royce, es porque quería hacer bachata, ¿sí entiendes? Lo estaba buscando, mis canciones que estaba componiendo ya estaba haciendo como una especie de bachata banda y me estaba funcionando. Entonces dije quiero, I want to sing bachata, like real bachata. That we did this song with Darel, it was more of a, you know, corridos, because I'm a corrido singer, so we talked about the streets and okay. Los barrios y cómo la gente empieza desde abajo. Entonces, como que me relacioné con Darel con eso, porque Darel viene muy calle también, su voz es muy grave. Entonces, yo también soy de voz grave. Entonces, como que, no sé, me tiene que gustar para que pueda suceder. I just gotta like the song to make it happen. If not, it's not gonna happen.
En un momento que quizás tú no quieras compartir en una colaboración, how do you maneuver those situations?
Well, right now, it's like, if I gotta say something, it's like everybody wants to do a collaboration right now. Okay. Like, everybody is in that mode. So, it's just timing, you know? Right now, I wanna start recording my music. I wanna start producing two albums. So, imagine, like, me getting involved in other productions or collabs. Sometimes it's possible, sometimes it's not possible.
And when someone hits you up and you don't wanna work with them, management handles that?
Yeah, it's just that's the way to...
Nothing personal,
nothing
right?
personal just, is, you know? Another way to handle it, and that's it.
I feel like if someone sends me something or if I send something to someone and it doesn't work out, I don't think it's ever bad blood, because it's music at the end of the day. If I really like the artist, okay, I would just be like, oh, maybe this isn't the song for me, but like, we could do something, let's do something. Like, if I really want to do something with somebody. But if I don't want to do something with somebody, then I'll probably just not respond, or I don't know.
So Kali, talk to us about Telepatía. Smash hit, congratulations.
Thank you.
You did it, you collabed with an amazing producer like Tiny. And in an interview, Tiny had mentioned, like, yo, this was something that we worked together and I was able to collaborate with. How was that process? How did this record come about? How did it happen? Because it's magical.
Thank you. Well, I had always known that I wanted to do the concept. I've been working on my English album around the same time I was working on Simiado. And so I had this song for the English album called Telepathy. I just didn't, it wasn't resonating with me. It didn't feel right. I went to Miami. I made probably like 15 songs in the course of like 3 days. Mm-hmm. And Telepatia was one of the songs that happened. Manuel made the beat, and as soon as I heard it, it just reminded me of a song that I already have called After the Storm, which was like the biggest song on my first album. So it felt very natural to me. It's very easy for me to flow on those type of sounds. And so I just slid.
After you cut that record, did you know right off the bat that it was gonna go where it went?
No, not at all. I was surprised for anything successful to come out of the album, because I definitely was, everyone kind of steered me away, like was like, oh, you know, it's not gonna be a good, you know, people in the Latin market want to cross over to the English market, why would you cross over to the Latin market, da da da. But this is my second album ever, so it's always been a dream of mine to do an entire album in Spanish. That's how I grew up speaking Spanglish.
So let's talk about a collaboration with a high profile producer. Is that a collaboration?
They're the ones that kind of sometimes have an idea and they can pitch off you. And I feel like that's the best type of vibe in the studio also, when you have a producer that knows what they want as well, because they're very particular about their sound. When I worked with El Guincho, I have this song called Goteo, and El Guincho is an amazing producer. He was amazing to work with because he inspired me for the song as well, like the flows and stuff like that. And his beat alone just inspired me for the topic of the song. And so I feel like that's so important, having producers that know exactly what they want and giving you, you know, also tips and feedback, is because it's happened to me before. Like, I work with some producers that have that high name profile and they ain't doing nothing. Like, they sleep.
More clout?
Yeah, they sleep in the studio. I'm like, come on, let's work. What you doing? It's happened.
I know you did a collaboration. One of Ricky Martin's first single. How was that?
Yeah, that was incredible.
I mean, Ricky Martin.
Oh, I know. It's crazy. I still can't believe it. Like, why me, Ricky? Why me? Thank you, though. Yeah, honestly, he came to me. He DM'd me. First, my manager had called me being like, yo, like, pick up your phone. Ricky trying to contact you. Like, he wants you on a song. And I was like, what? And then, like, I checked my DMs and he had written to me. And obviamente, creciendo no solamente siendo Latina, but also creciendo en Nueva York, Ricky era un pilar muy, muy importante. Wherever you go, everybody knows who Ricky Martin is. Like, such an honor for him to want to work with me, somebody that's, I feel like I'm still low-key in my way. Like, I still haven't, like, you know, I'm not winning no Grammys here. Just kidding. but I feel like I'm still kind of low-key. And it was so incredible for him to want to collab with me. Like, I still can't believe it. And it was such a fire song, and it took me a minute to do it too, because I was so nervous. I was like, oh my God, like I overthought it a lot. And I was like, oh my God, this has to be so good. I have to make the lyrics so thoughtful. And then I was like, wait, but like, no, I'm not gonna do that. This is like a fun song. It's sexy, like he's doing sexy, fun lyrics. Like, I'm not gonna overthink it too much. And then I finally got in the studio and it came naturally, and the rest is history.
When it comes to new artists collaborating, when is it a co-sign and when is it a clout chase?
If you have a song already that is a good song, then why not, you know, just go with your song? Being a new artist, it's better if you go in by yourself, you know, than go in with help.
Yo empecé solo.
Okay.
Entonces, como que hice
mi... Ya estás acostumbrado.
Hice mi camino solo, pero, okay. Pero cuando tu primer éxito puede ser una colaboración, pues después tienes que como que prove
yeah.
them that you're
for
yeah,
sure
yeah
for sure,
for sure. Like
that
you
happens.
Were saying that you did a whole album by yourself. Mm-hmm. That's like proving that that's you, you know. That's
yeah, exactly. I feel like sometimes that happens, like you said, people get lost in the sauce, you know. Sometimes when somebody collabs with somebody too soon and they're already so big, and like you have to just keep topping that, and it's kind of hard. Like, how are you gonna, I'm not gonna name names, but no, like it happens. Lots
of
people, you know, not
it,
in
right?
a bad way, because yeah. it's not their fault. You know, they're taking an opportunity that, hey, like a big artist wanted to do this song.
Culture
it's amazing, you know. But sometimes I feel like it's happened to me before. Like I've had opportunities with artists that I've wanted to collab with, but I know that it's not right for me to collab with them in the moment that it was, because I know that it's gonna make me blow up, and then I don't know what's gonna happen from there. Yo planeo todo, estoy súper como que, no, porque después esto va a pasar y después todos van a pensar esto. So I'm always like, I've had to say no to people that I've wanted to work with before that are like super big artists, and it's just because it's the timing, you know, and I feel like I had to put myself first.
Just because two people that got something going on get on a song together doesn't mean that the song is gonna be, you know, a hit. It doesn't mean that the song is gonna do what you think it's gonna do. At the end of the day, I think music is music, and you don't necessarily need to, all those things are like little shortcuts, or like if you wanna do it, then you do it.
Can an artist do too much collaborations?
I don't think you could ever do too much if there are things that you really wanted to do, but I think that if it shows that it's like forced, or that you just did the collaborations because it's like, oh yeah, maybe y'all's managers are friends, or maybe the label or whatever was like, oh, put on my new artist and da da da. That kind of stuff, it just kind of shows. I don't know, it just doesn't feel as genuine. And at the end of the day, music is art, so I feel like it should feel genuine.
Where does everybody stand? ¿Dónde estamos, mi gente? Colaboraciones. ¿Es un amigo? Oh no, is it a friend or a foe?
But I feel like it's beautiful. I think it's amazing to collab with people that you really connect with, and when it really hits, I think that's what makes Palos for me. Like, cuando algo es real.
And the culture can notice.
Even better when it's like two artists that people really want together, and they really like have a connection as well.
Okay. Depende de la intención que esté detrás del proyecto. Porque si es una intención como más.
Por la fama,
negocio, por los números. Entonces como que no puede lograrse a lo mejor ese palo, como dice ella. Pero si la intención es más de amistad con esas energías, creo que es cuando llegan ese tipo de colaboraciones que gustan y que hacen algo, ¿no?
And even if the song isn't a hit, like even if you just like had fun collaborating, you're always gonna remember. I have so many songs that I love that I feel like haven't been appreciated like that. And I'm like, damn, like why don't they love this like me? And you know, I still love it just as much. Just doesn't matter if other people don't.
For me, I've always made it very clear that with my career and since I started making music, I never really made music to be on lists or to be on, you know, whatever. I've always known what my purpose is, and I'm gonna do what I came to do regardless. So I don't think that it's necessary, but I think that, yeah, if it's something that you want to do. Like for me, when I first started, like I was saying that I collaborated with big artists, that was just because they reached out to me and they had songs that I like. People just messaged me like, oh, I f*** with your tape or da 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 da. And it was people that I really respected. So I think it's fun. It's always something fun to do, but I don't think it's necessary.
Bueno, ya que somos amigos, we're all friends here now.
Who's friends with you?
Damn, yo, I'm out of here, yo. I'm out. Damn, yo, keep that pop, keep that pop. Sensitive.
No, I'm just playing.
Are we gonna see a collaboration between y'all one day?
The Spanglish girls might get together.
Ooh, so I might work on the most Spanglish twice.
Me and Gerardo might drop a record. You know what I'm saying? Llorón. Llorón. You're crazy, man. This was so much fun. Thank you for keeping it honest, open, and transparent. Mi gente, we'll see you next week. Cultura Clash, we out. Peace.